glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Akron is on the field hoping to use that home crowd to put a little bit of extra zip in the offense and light up that scoreboard today. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
City in the state is the site for this college football showdown.
And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Penn State is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. Ivy fields it at the two. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Tailback brought down for a loss.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 24. Now he tries to buy some time. Decides to slide. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
Two times, two times. Four down, four down. I got
number three. I got three. There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
I'd say that went about as well as the defense hoped it would.
The secondary decided to drop back into coverage here, and there was nobody open for the quarterback to deliver the ball to. Good job by the D.
Peterson, the return man. Peterson fields it at the 30, and he makes it out to about the 41-yard line.
Andrews' physical ability, Kirk, you add that to the fact he's got a great attitude, and he's some kind of special player.
He's very special, and you could almost feel that when you're talking with the coaches this week. Their eyes kind of light up when you're talking about what he brings to the table. Of course, he can get downfield and make those plays, but the thing that I think stands out is he's unselfish. He's willing to block. He's willing to do the little things. And I think that's why he has so much respect and admiration from the coaching staff.
Davis gets 7 yards on the play. From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. And down he goes at the 42-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
He scrambled. He lost the ball. The defense scoops it. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
And he's taken down at the 37.
That makes it second and two.
Hey,
It's second down, two to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Pretty good gain on the play by the halfback.
And that shows you why he's such a weapon as a ball carrier. Good gain for the offense.
Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
First and 10, ball on the 47-yard line. Nice run up the middle. Gets out to about the 42-yard line.
No gain. Third down.
From the 42-yard line. Third down.
Mike 56.
Fires out to his wideout.
Perfect timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. That's a big gain and more than enough for the first down.
Second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 20.
Let's go.
Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Miller was the intended receiver on the play.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Flushed out and he's going to get sacked. So they're going to go for it here.
Three down. Mike 56.
He's wrapped up for the sack. The defense holds, and the ball will change hands. Every drive is important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That'll make it second and four.
We've played one quarter. Still no score. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we're dead even. Makes it out to about the 50.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 50. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
That's a gain of 15 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Man, left.
taken down
at about the 35. From the 35-yard line, second down. And he has it on the corner. He's at the 20. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Makes a move, and he's in for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. So that's a six-play, 65-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
He gets out to about the 25-yard line. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Complete. It's the freshman. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line. He's scrambling. Tackle
around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Mike 56, Mike 56.
Pressured and brought down.
Call the loss of 6 yards. That brings us third and 10.
Third and 10. Ball on the 36.
Tight end, Mike. Four down. Mike 56.
Here we go. Flag.
He sails it long. Gordon was the intended target on the play. They couldn't pick up the first down, so they'll have to punt this one away.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Moore is the punter.
At the 41.
You're always looking for the home run return. The big highlight didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Penn State is up a score.
Let's go.
Brought down at the 49. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. First down.
Into the halfback on the screen.
He's pushed out of bounds.
Around the 32-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 32-yard line. First down.
to that quickly. And he's tackled around the 15-yard line.
Yeah, the defense looked a little sluggish there, and they can do better than that.
Penn State's going to take their first time out of the half. Now he's scrambling. And they got him.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
It's second and 15. Ball on the 20-yard line. Grabs it and hammered right there. Penn State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Penn State is up by a touchdown. Tackle made at the 6. It's fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Penn State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. Kick is up, and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. He might have a chance. The 50. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown, Zips. And for Johnson, he's got himself a 100-yard rushing performance.
What you like is how clever he is at allowing the play to take shape before he makes his move. That shows vision and maturity.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. And he adds the extra point. I have a feeling this ball is going nowhere near the return man with this kickoff, most likely to end the half. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. So both teams will go to the locker room looking to make some adjustments and find some second-half offense. The Nittany Lions in front, 10-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step wrap, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David, but could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese? Sometimes, pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But, you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, you know, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. I mean, you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra-successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
The
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one.
Peterson from the nine. And down he goes at the 41-yard line.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play.
Penn State is up by three.
Throws complete. He's got room to work.
They'll bring him down
at about the 45. First down, 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 45.
Quick shot. The defender tips it away.
You know, for you young cornerbacks and young defensive backs, this is a great example of just being smart and efficient as a defender. Instead of taking a chance and going for that interception, he was smart. He got in position, knocked the football away, and didn't give the receiver a chance to make a play on the football.
He's tackled around the 39-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He's got it with room to run. And down he goes around the 28-yard line.
Miller with the tackle at the 28-yard line. First down.
Man left, man left. Four down. Watch 98.
Gives it off. Tries to get around the corner. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Just throws this one away. Penn State is up a field goal.
Tries to buy some time.
And he's taken down at about the 11.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 11-yard line, it's first down. There's another pass to the tight end, and he's got it. That's a great tackle at the 2.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and 1.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Finds the tight end over the middle. Touchdown. He hit the big tight end for 6 on that one.
As a quarterback, you like the tight end inside the 10-yard line because they have a knack for finding the opening. And then you can just drill it in there.
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Ivy from the 2 makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He gets to about the 27-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Much room there as they try to work the left side.
Third down.
Oh, Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
Can't ask for much more than a three and out. Great job, defense.
That'll make it fourth and two.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. And he's tackled at the 50-yard line. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
From their own 48-yard line, second down. Scrambling around. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
That'll bring up third and six.
Here's the halfback on the screen. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game.
Didn't get all of that one.
Room around the corner, out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 16. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Wilson goes with a play fake, nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it.
Miller was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 28-yard line, second down. He's taken down at the 26-yard line.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll make it third and 13.
So with one quarter remaining, the Nittany Lions in front, 17-7. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He wants it all. Well, they've got the lead, and they come up with a big stop, and it looks like they're going to get the football back.
Fourth down.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
He's at the 30, and they make the stop.
Around the 22-yard line.
He carried that one for a huge gain.
You know what? You can see the ball carrier showcase his speed. Once he got into the open field, he just turned on the jets and flew.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Right around the 16-yard line.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
The 10, and that sets them up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the 5, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
It's third and goal from the 10. They'll probably look to the air here. There's a strike complete. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Penn State to kick. From the 1, brought down at the 21-yard line. The Nittany Lions have a defense that's a sight to behold, Kirk.
Well, they just play with a chip on their shoulder. They are all over the field. The defensive line knows their job. The linebackers, the safeties, the corners, everybody plays as one, and they've been fun to watch today.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He scrambled. Brought down right around the 32-yard line. Throwing right, pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he is drilled at the 38.
You know, Brad, I know this game is out of reach, but I just love to see that these guys haven't given up. And there's more to a game than just thinking about winning and losing. As a coach, you want to see your team not give up and continue to try to go out and execute.
Looks like he's going to run.
Tackle made at the 30.
Eagle! Eagle! Makes it second and two.
Makes the catch, and look out. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
That's good enough for another Akron first down.
First down. Big opportunity to score here inside the five. It's first down and goal. He's going to try and scramble. He got a lot of jersey on that play. Not too much argument about this call.
Holding offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
That brings him second and goal.
Just over a minute left. Fires complete over the middle. They'll bring him down around the 9-yard line. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Just a minute remains in this football game. So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
There he goes. He gets to about the 24-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 24. Backfield.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Andrew's performance today, not what he was looking for, but he's going to take the win anytime.
Well, hopefully he's still proud of the effort by the team. I know he didn't put up the numbers that he wanted individually, but this is a team game. They got the victory. He should be proud and happy about that.
So that wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.